I'm Alan Hall and welcome to WeatherGuard. Here at WeatherGuard, we make lightning protection easy. We're going to talk about wind turbine blades today, issues with wind turbine blades, and I'm going to name off the top three issues that we see a lot of on wind turbine blades. So most wind turbine blades have some sort of minimal lightning protection system. Probably the most common protection system you will see in a wind turbine is a down conductor, basically a big copper cable running through the center of the blade, and then at a minimum of a receptor or a couple of receptors, which are the size of maybe an inch diameter, that sit on the blade surface somewhere near the tip typically. So you have two places where lightning can attach the blade, and then you get this down conductor that runs through the blade itself, down through the tower, and all the way back down to the ground. That's your basic lightning protection system, been in use for a long time on wind turbine blades. So the things we see that are issue with that sort of basic lightning protection system on wind turbine blades is, one, the lightning protection of those receptors is not very efficient. Now, in the laboratory, when those blades have been qualified, you're dealing with a brand new blade right off the manufacturing line, you're going off, you're running a lightning test on it, everything is fine. Once the blade ages, it becomes more porous. The fiberglass breaks down, the epoxy systems break down, all the resin systems break down. The blade becomes electrically porous. And that's where you see lightning penetrating different places besides the receptor. The second thing we see is just a lot of lightning happening off the receptor in weird ways, right? So the receptor usually being in the middle of the blade, you can have lightning attachments that are coming through the blade to get to the receptor. That's a function of the receptor and sort of the conditions inside the blade. That's a problem area. The third area we see is just general wear and tear. Obviously, you would like to have those wind turbines running continuously through the rain and the snow and the sleet and everything else, the hot temperatures, the cold temperatures. That has an effect on your lightning protection system. Particularly, it can, one, remove some of the grounding and bonding features. They become aged over time, become higher resistances, or more importantly, your lightning protection system just isn't as efficient as it once was because of all the weathering. Same thing for the blade structure itself. The blade structure begins to break down. We at WeatherGuard have a product called Strike Tape, which we manufacture, which is a blade receptor enhancement feature. It makes the receptors much more likely to accept lightning strikes. It basically directs all the lightning strikes to that receptor in a very simple way. It's simple to install, quick to install, and very long lasting. So we can take those existing wind turbine blades, quickly modify them, simply modify them to really enhance the lightning protection systems on existing blades without a lot of modification. So if you are in the process of designing a wind turbine blade or you're having wind turbine lightning blade issues out in the field, we've been doing this for a long time. We have a lot of experience wind turbine blade design. So if you have any questions or you're working on a project, please give us a call today and we can help.